Good evening, everyone. This is Tube 87. I hope you all had a wonderful and blessed weekend. Now, first thing I'm going to say is that there are a lot of groups out there claiming that they are the Heavenly Father's chosen people, be it because of race, belief, nationality, or what have you. I am not going to pass judgment on what people believe or what they think. What I'm going to do is show you in Scripture what I've come across as the most positive illustration of whom He says His people in the last days are going to be. So, with that being said, let me not waste any time. Let's get started with all His people. Okay, people, we're going to start with Isaiah 56. We're going to read verses 1 through 7, starting with verse 1. Thus saith the Lord, keep ye judgment and do justice, for my salvation is near to come, and my righteousness to be revealed. Verse 2. Blessed is the man that doeth this, and the son of man that layeth hold on it, that keepeth the Sabbath from polluting it, and keepeth his hand from doing any evil. Verse 3. Neither let the son of the stranger that have joined himself to the Lord speak, saying, the Lord hath utterly separated me from his people. Neither let the eunuch say, behold, I am a dry tree. 4. For thus saith the Lord unto the eunuchs that keep my Sabbath and choose the things that please me and take hold of my covenant. 5. Even unto them will I give in mine house and within my walls a place and a name better than the sons and of daughters. I will give them an everlasting name that shall not be cut off. Verse 6. Also the sons of the stranger that joined themselves to the Lord to serve him, to love the name of the Lord, to be his servants, every one that keepeth the Sabbath from polluting it and taketh hold of my covenant. Verse 7. Even them will I bring to my holy mountain and make them joyful in my house of prayer. Their burnt offerings and their sacrifices shall be accepted upon mine altar. For mine house shall be called an house of prayer for all people. Now, in short, these seven verses, Isaiah 56, 1 through 7, it is simply talking about the Father telling us that He is soon to be coming and He will accept all people locally, from other lands, or what have you. Those that love Him, keep His laws, keep the Sabbath and don't pollute it, meaning to keep the Sabbath and doing His will, turning away from the things that you want to find delight in and keep His things and find delight in them. I'm going to go over a few of them right quick so that you understand that this is what it's saying. We're going to go back to verse 1. If we look at verse 1, it says, for my salvation is near to come. Now, if you look at Daniel 2:44, it reads, it says, and in these days of these kings shall the God of heaven set up a kingdom which shall never be destroyed, and the kingdom shall not be left to other people, but it shall break in pieces and consume all these kingdoms, and it shall stand forever. So verse 1 in Isaiah 56 is telling us that he is going to set up a kingdom that will stand forever, and all these other kingdoms, governments, politicians, popes, all these governments, all these leaders are going to be destroyed. He will destroy all these other kingdoms, and his is going to be the one that reigns forever. Next, if we look at verse 2, it says that he that keepeth the Sabbath from polluting it. Now, if we look at Isaiah 58:13, it reads, it says, if thou turn away thy foot from the Sabbath from doing thy pleasure on my holy day and call the Sabbath a delight, the holy of the Lord honorable, and shall honor him, not doing thine own ways, nor finding thine own pleasure, nor speaking thine own words. So, he says that those who keep the Sabbath and don't violate it, don't pollute it. You turn away from those things you find delight in and turn to the Sabbath and look upon it as a delight and honor the will of the Father. These are individuals that he's looking for. Now, we go to verse 3. It says, the son of a stranger. Now, in Acts 8:27, it speaks about a man from Ethiopia, a eunuch. So it's telling us that the son of a stranger, this individual or individuals from other lands, Acts 27 is the illustration of that. That's why it's referenced to Acts 8:27. Now this man from Ethiopia was a eunuch. Now in verse 4, remember it reads, it says, for thus saith the Lord unto the eunuchs that keep my Sabbaths and choose the things that pleasure me and take hold of my covenant. Verse 5 says, even unto them will I give in mine house and within mine walls a place and a name better than the sons and of daughters. I will give them an everlasting name that shall not be cut off. So what it's saying is, or what the Father is saying is, that even strangers from other lands, Acts 8:27, tell us that this eunuch was Ethiopian. So we will be clear that he's not just talking about Hebrews, Jews, or what have you. He's letting us know that anyone from anywhere, as long as they do his will, keep his commandments, keep his covenant, love him, keep the Sabbath, and all these things, he would accept into his house, and he would give them a name everlasting. Now, also in verse 5, we have several references. 1 Timothy 3:15 tells us that the church is the church or his people of the living Elohim, or the living God, as some people would say. This is his people. 1 Corinthians 3:17 says that the temple of his is holy. And it asks the question, which temple are you? Are you going to be one that's set apart from the rest of the world, or are you going to be one of his people? Set apart, special, holy, sanctified. 2 Timothy 2:20 says that some vessels are to honor and some are to dishonor. So then finally, and all this is referenced to verse 5 in Isaiah 56, John 1:12, it says, for as many as received him, he gave power even unto them that believe on his name. How clear can this be? He is saying anyone. And already gave us the illustration of the Ethiopian, a eunuch no less, from another land, anyone that received him. So as far as I'm concerned, he's not being exclusive. He's accepting of any of us. Verse 6 says that all that join themselves to the Lord to serve him. And then finally in verse 7, it says that the house of his house will be a house of prayer for all people. Now, if we look at Malachi 1:11, it says that his name shall be great among the heathen and Gentile. So simply and clearly, all it's saying, his name will be great among all people, not just this group or this group, all people that love him, that believe on him and keep his commandments and keep the Sabbath. He's clear about all these things. So I'm going to leave it there and make this simple and short, because Isaiah 56, 1 through 7 is as clear as it can get about who he's looking for, who he's going to accept. But like I say, we all have free will and we can believe individually what we want based on what we choose to believe and what we choose to follow. And with that being said, remember, the Heavenly Father didn't call on us to be successful. He called on us to be faithful. This is 2Base 7. I'm out.